Hi friends, we will now read one shloka which is again from Mahabharata. It is talking about how bad people tend to blame the good people. Bad people, they are themselves bad, there is no problem. They can be bad, but they don't keep quiet with that. They also try to blame the good people. So this is the shloka about it. I will read the shloka, I will explain it, then we will finally wind up repeating the shloka. निर्गुणास्त्वेव भूयिष्ठम् आत्मसंभावितानराः दोषैरन्यान् गुणवतः क्षिपन्ति आत्मगुणक्षयात्. सो दिस इज फ्रॉम द महाभारत द एंड पोर्शन शांति पर्व वेर भीष्म द एग्जैक्ट कॉन्टेक्स्ट आई हैव नॉट नोटेड. इट इज फ्रॉम द शांति पर्व. So this is about how a fellow with so many problems within himself, so many defects in himself. So the man, he has got a lot of self-admiration. So he is about saying, the shloka is talking about a person who is Atma Sambhavita. The first line is talking about Nirgunastveva Bhuishtam Atma Sambhavita Naraha. This Atma Sambhavita. Atma Sambhavita means one who is thinking himself as very, very high and mighty. So that is a sort of self-admiration, and it can go to the extent of what is called megalomania. There is a word called megalomania. So that is a person, he thinks no end of himself. So that is the type of person. But then okay, you can have megalomania, then fine. But then you are also blaming others. So that is what this shloka is talking about. So nirgunastu eva, the people who are devoid of character, nirguna. Guna means virtue or a character, a good trait in a person's character. That is what is called a gunam. Nirguna are people who are devoid of good qualities, people who are devoid of virtues. So such people, teyeva bhuishtam, quite often, atma sambhavita naraha. They take pride in their own greatness, atma sambhavita. In fact, this atma sambhavita word, it is from Bhagavad Gita. Of course, Vyasa himself is the writer of Bhagavad Gita also. So, Atma Sambhavita is also there in Bhagavad Gita. It is in the context of what is called, say, the divine wealth and the demonic wealth. So, the Gita, distinguishes between two types of human nature. One is a divine nature, the other is a demonic nature. So, that means there are certain qualities which are designated as divine qualities. There are certain other qualities which are designated as demonic qualities. One of the demonic qualities is this, Atma Sambhavana. Atma Sambhavana is taking great pride in one's own, greatness. Assumed greatness, let us say, not real greatness. Assumed greatness. So that is Atma Sambhavitaha, Stabdhaha, Dhanamana, Madanvitaha, etc., etc. There is a shloka in, the 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. That is called Daiva, Asura, Sampad, Vibhaga Yoga. That is... That portion of Gita which is talking about Daivi Sampat and Asuri Sampat, that is the demonic wealth it is called and divine wealth it is called. All the divine virtues, whatever good qualities which a person has, it is somewhat like a wealth. So because that gives him a lot of respect. In fact, people give a lot of respect to him by only seeing those qualities. So that is a sort of divine wealth. And whereas demonic wealth, people may be afraid, but then they do not respect him, they do not love him. Demonic wealth also is wealth, but then it is something which is condemned, it is something which is hated, which is disliked. So that is what is the demonic wealth. So here, nirgunastveva bhuishtam atma sambhavita naraha. So these people, they are megalomaniac in nature, but then they do not stop with that. Doshaihi anyan gunavataha. So the other virtuous persons, they look at the other virtuous person, anyan gunavataha, that is the people who are virtuous. So those people are blamed by these nirgunaha. Doshair anyan gunavataha kshipanti atma gunakshayat. Kshipanti means they attribute all bad qualities to the good people. Why do they do that? Atma gunakshayat, that is because they themselves lack character. They themselves do not have that strength of character, Atma Gunakshayat, that is because of their own lack of character. because of lack of character, they blame other people. So that is what this particular shloka says. So it is okay, as I said, it is okay if they are megalomaniac, but they attribute defects. So that is the shloka. Of course, there is not much of grammar here. That is nirgunaha plus tu becomes nirgunastu eva. Eva is only bhuishtam. Bhuishtam means they tend to be like that. They tend to be so very much or quite often they are like that. Atma sambhavitaha naraha are people. Atma gunakshayat, because of their own lack of character. And kshipanti, they attribute with defects. Gunavataha anyan, the other virtuous persons. Gunavataha anyan. Gunavataha is in dvitiya bahuvachanam here. Gunavata anyan gunavataha, that is dvitiya bahuvachanam. Anyan gunavataha, the other virtuous persons, they blame them or they attribute defects in them. So that is the shloka. We will read it. Nirgunastveva bhuyishtam.
Nirgunastveva bhuyishtam.
Atmasambhavitanaraha.
Atmasambhavitanaraha.
Doshairanyan gunavataha.
Doshairanyan gunavataha.
Kshipanti atmagunakshayat.
Kshipanti atmagunakshayat.
Okay, fine.